We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Ought to be a good one here between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Houston Astros. Into the box now, Yandy Diaz. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Two balls and a strike to the Rays first baseman.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
The 2-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
Number 8.
So now to the plate, Brandon Lau. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. 2-2. This is pulled into right. Therefore, it is the Gold Glover Reddick, and he's got it one away. At the plate, Joey Wendell.
At third, the third baseman.
Diaz, base runner at first with one out. Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one out double.
That is good. The right fielder, Austin Meadows.
In now, Austin Meadows. Count still full, 3-2. Payoff pitch one more time. Fouled off. Again, another foul ball. And here's the 3-2 from him. Fly ball out toward left center field. Springer on the run. He's there to make the catch. And here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. The run is in to score, and they take an early 1-0 lead. Striding forward now is the DH, Yoshi Tsutsugo. And a great chance here for the Rays to add on in just the first inning. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Rays DH.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open,
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Now at the plate, George Springer. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A ball and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. George Springer sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. 3-2.
Gonna be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Line drive, base hit. Around first, digging for two. At the plate now, Michael Brantley. In the dirt here. And he'll rein it in as the count moves to 1-2. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Fly ball out to right field. Meadows moving back. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. So stepping in, Yuli Gurriel, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. hit sharply on the ground to the left. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. But the recovery is too late at first, and the run is in to score. At the plate, Kyle Tucker. Three balls and a strike to Houston's left fielder.
Hey, sometimes it doesn't go exactly according to plan. Two aces on the mound. We thought they were going to throw up donuts all game. Both teams are able to score. Let's see which one settles down quicker.
3-1. Here it is. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. The set and the 1-1. And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. Previous history with Blake Snell. He's gone 2-for-6. Correa in front. 3 balls and a strike.
3-1 here. You have to make a good pitch on the mound. Grooving one here rarely works in your favor unless the hitter tries to do too much with it.
This is line to left. Margot is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Digging in, Willy Adames. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Oh, had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. Line towards center field. Springer is there, and he has it for the first out. Settling in now, Kevin Kiermaier. Now the 2-1 pitch.
You rarely see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle, and man, as a hitter, probably a good chance you're not going to see that pitch again.
Yanked high and deep down the line in right, and it's a foul ball. Full count to the Rays center fielder. Manuel Margot, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. Slap hard the opposite way, but this will hang up just a bit as it's taken in chest high for a tough second out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. The 1-1. Hit back up the middle. Reined in. Onto the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and that brings up the former Gold Glover, Josh Reddick. The 1-2. This is on the ground over to first. He's got it. And he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted. And that'll bring up Aledmys Díaz. A 1-1. Bases are empty, 1 man out. All even now, 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2. So bases are empty here with 2 gone. And up next, the former Angel, Martin Maldonado. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number 1. And that will bring in Yandy Diaz. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. popped him up. Gurriel has room in foul territory. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. So striding in, Brandon Lau hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
A ball and two strikes now. And this pitch is looked at for a ball, and that'll even the count to the Rays second baseman at 2-2. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here, 3-2 with two away.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he pushed it just a bit too much. It'll wind up a foul ball. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Striding in once again, George Springer, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. The 1-1. Fouled away. The 1-2. Is a changeup that's looked at for a ball. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Third baseman,
and that'll bring up Alex Bregman. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. 2-2.
Man, this has been a game filled of a lot of swings and misses. Not very many confident swings, and this team up there, they'd swing at a butterfly right now if it flew in front of the plate. Lots of swings, lots of misses, a lot of ugly at-bats for this team right now.
The designated hitter, Michael.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Meadows is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So it's a runner at first with two gone, and digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. A 1-1 count, here's the pitch. Slapped hard the opposite way, and that's a fair ball as it'll head for the 326 sign in right. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
The left fielder, number 30, Kyle Tucker.
Into the box, Kyle Tucker. It's just off the inside part of the plate. It's 3-1.
Got a good spot to be in right now. Pitcher's fall behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
And this misses for ball four. The second walkie surrendered here in the first three innings. To 1-2 now. One and two. Here it is. And he fouls this one off. A 1-2 pitch. And he comes back to get him. So a great job pitching out of it with the bases loaded. All set for the start of the fourth. And that'll give way to the third baseman, Joey Wendell. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Count is 2-1.
swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Another try at 2-2. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third now with a strikeout. And there's one away. One run, two hits, one error in the ballgame for Tampa Bay. Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. The 1-2. Struck him out. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Yoshi Tsutsugo. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
To the plate now, Willie Adames. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that brings up the former Gold Glover Josh Reddick. Inside and low, 2-1. And it's fouled away. This one smoked the other way, high and deep to left. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning. Digging in for his second at bat, Aledmys Diaz, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. 2-2. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. 3-2 pitch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Meadows is over just a few steps to his left as he takes it for out number two. Coming to the plate now, Martin Maldonado. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Grounded down the third baseline. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three. Stepping in, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll lead it off against Zach Greinke to open up the inning. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Well, we all know he can burn on a base pass, right? But that's a little tougher to do when you've got a nice goose egg on your leg. It's tough to do like that.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Reddick has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first out. Here now is Mike Zunino. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 3-2 pitch. Kiermaier's running. Just hung in there on that one. He'll try it again, 3-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Yandy Diaz. He singled and popped out in his first two at-bats. Runner back safely. Runners off for second. Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. Popped him up. Gurriel has it, and the side is retired. Brendan McKay, a 6'2" left-hander, jogs in to take over on the hill.
Number 49.
So the batting order turns over now, and set to go George Springer. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. The 1-1 home. His fastball taken high for a ball.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Count even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. Last time through was a base hit. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
And this one's tapped foul at home plate. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Grounder down the line at third. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. Throw into second. And he is safe at second base as he legs out a double. Standing in now, Yuli Gurriel. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. Three and one.
Well, that's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
So stepping in, Kyle Tucker, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. And that's taken for a called strike two. Hit on the ground to third, scooped up, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Brandon Lau. The 1-1 home. Fouled off.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. The throw down to first, one away. Ready once again, Joey Wendell. 1-for-2, including a double back in the first. 1-1. Is laid off for ball two.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at-bat. One might be coming right here.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. One out, nobody on. Popped him up. Correa shading to his right. And he makes the catch for the second out. So here's the cleanup hitter. Austin Meadows comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Game. fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. He was laid off and the count runs full. And with just 5 2/3 innings under his belt, he's about to hit the century mark in his pitch count now.
Yeah, Matty B, and the way baseball's.
And the third baseman is there to make the catch, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Carlos Correa. Now the 1-1 pitch. He is a heater in there for a strike. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. Reined in. And that's the first down. So one gone in the inning, and that brings up the right fielder, Josh Reddick. One run, five hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Reddick behind the ball and two strikes. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Margot's on the move. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
Now
ready for another shot now. Aledmys Diaz. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 1-1. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three and the side is retired. C.N.L. Pettis is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 52.
Digging in and looking for more, Yoshitsugo. Tsugo. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Matty, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
1-2 now. Tried to shoot the corner, and he missed it. 2-2.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
Here's a ground ball out to the shortstop, Correa. Fielded cleanly, and the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. In now, Willy Adames. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. The 1-1. Misses, ball two. Pettis, a Cuban-born ball player. He's in his rookie year here at the big league level. And a slider's in for a strike. It's 2-2.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Now back, the third beat, Kevin Kiermaier.
So now to the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Swing and a liner. But unfortunately, right at the shortstop for the second out. So a runner at second, two down now, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder, Manuel Margot. And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle. Two and two.
I'm going to need to see a better game plan out of the hitter right here. That ball was at his eyes.
I tried to backdoor him there, but it's a full count now. 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's throwing it.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And that is just shy of the box seats, off the top of the wall.
Now that, the catcher, Mike Zunino.
At the plate, Mike Zunino. That's foul off to the left side as he makes him do it again, 3-2. And another foul ball. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Reddick has a read on it. And the inning is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, we join for the traditional 7-inning stretch.
Last half of the seventh here. And up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
Maldonado behind the ball and two strikes. This is on the ground over to first. He's got it. And that's out number one. Here's George Springer. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. And a full count to George Springer. It's 3-2. Alex Bregman waits on deck. A swing and a ground ball to third. And this goes right through his glove on into left field. At the plate now, Alex Bregman. Inside here with the hard stuff, and it's 2-1 now. Ripped down the first base line. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. As a look, now the pitch. Michael Brantley, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle. Line drive to left. And that'll get down for a base hit. So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Stepping in now, Michael Brantley. On the ground to short. Could this be two? There's one. On to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. Brad Peacock has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 41.
Digging in to try it again, Yandy Diaz. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A bouncer up the middle. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single.
Now back, number 8.
Into the box, Brendan Lau. Lifted the other way out to left center. On the run is Tucker, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. So a runner at first now with one away, and digging in next will be Joey Wendell. The 1-2. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery. Softly hit down to third. Likely no shot at two. To second for one. Turn throw is in time. How about that? They do turn two, and it gets him out of the inning. Diego Castillo is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 53.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And here comes the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. Here's the 1-1 pitch. A They have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2. High in the air out towards shallow right. Meadows has it, and there's one away. Stepping up to the plate, Kyle Tucker. A couple of walks for him thus far. Eighth inning of this low-scoring affair. 3-1 our score. Lays off the slider that time. 2-1. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
In my opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count. Josh Reddick would be next. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Andre Scrub enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Meadows. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Inside ball one.
Popped up. Gurriel just to the right of the mound. And that's the first out of the inning. Now with the plate, Yoshi Tsutsugo. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Correa backs up and takes care of it. Two away. Stepping into the box, Willy Adames. He came across to score after doubling in his last at-bat. To 2-2 now.
Gotta love a reliever that comes in firing bullets, and his fastball is a good one.
Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. And this one misses inside a ball. He walked him, and they've got themselves a 2-out base runner. So coming to the plate, Kevin Kiermaier hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can ask. You can't control the result sometimes, Matty. Just unlucky with the placement.
2 balls and a strike to count. 2-1, here it is. Pulled toward right center field. Reddick giving chase. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Nick Anderson comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 70. Nick.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And digging in is the outfielder, Josh Reddick. Very high, 2-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Yeah, well, down two. You better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. He spoils another one, and we'll do it again. Ready with another two-strike offering. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. Into the box now, Aledmys Diaz. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Drilled right back up the middle. And there's his first base hit in this one. Miles Straw will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. In now, Martin Maldonado. And he fouls this one off. Ready with another two-strike offering.
Hey, this isn't going to be an easy save. These guys are making them work for this one.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Now better.
Now in the box, George Springer. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. The 1-1 pitch. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his M.O. is.
Hit to first. One there, and that is going to do it. The Rays are off to the AL Championship Series.
Well, they know their work is nowhere close to being finished, but they've handled their business so far, winning here to punch their ticket to the next round and a possible trip to the World Series. Well done.
And, guys, a very important outing turned in on the mound for the man you see right there. He was a big factor, of course, and is the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award.
Well, it's not that often a relief pitcher that's not a closer gets props like this, but this time I think it's well-deserved. They needed him in some tough situations, and he passed every test with flying colors.
For the left-hander Dan Plesac, Mark DeRosa, and our entire crew, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been the American League Division Series.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Rays, 3 runs, 6 hits, 1 error. They left 5 men on base. For the Astros, 1 run on 9 hits. No errors. They left 11 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 42 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Minute Maid Park, 41,168. The Astros thank you for attending and remind you to please drive home safely.